So what do you do when you fall down? Get back up. Everybody knows to get back up. But I tell you, there are some times in life where you fall down and you feel like you don't have the strength to get back up. You see, I will try 100 times to get up, and if I fail 100 times, if I fail and I give up, do you think that I'm ever going to get up? No. But if I fail, I try again and again and again.
You know, teenage mom got pregnant at 17, you know, and, you know, I just been failing my whole life, man. My old dude didn't come in my life until I was about 30, dropped out of high school, took 12 years to get a 4-year degree. Man, I mastered failing, you know. So I'm like so many kids, man, in trouble with the law, in trouble in school, in trouble at home, just trouble, trouble, trouble. And somebody came in my life and spoke life into me. It was like, kid, you got game. Like, you a leader. You got a mouthpiece. Like, you gonna do great things, and you need to get your stuff together. And they challenged me, you know, and I accepted the challenge, and I just fell forward. You know, I learned from my mistakes, and I turned my mistakes into a book. I turned my mistakes into a message.
See, you've got some talents and abilities right now you have that if you don't challenge yourself to use those talents and abilities, you'll never ever discover the full effect that they can have on achieving all the things that you want to achieve. Most people go through life never using the power they have. You have enormous power to begin to create all the things that you want in your life experience that most people go through life never using. Just find one thing and just decide that you're going to work with it until it gives you the blessing that you want, and don't let up on it. Just keep right on working it and working it and working it, and knowing that whatever you do, you can better your best, that you can get better at it, that whatever you are achieving right now, it's only a tip of the iceberg of what's possible for you.
And so many people are dying with dreams. They dying with books inside of them, CDs inside of them, acting skills inside of them, athletes inside of them. Like, so much is inside of them that they never get out because they don't want it, you know. And I just know something about humans. You've seen mothers like weigh 140 pounds pick up a car when their babies are trapped under a car. Like, she 140. How she pick up the ride? But she wanted it. Like, she wanted her baby to live. And you take her the next day and you try to get her to lift the car, man, she can't touch that ride. But the day before, that adrenaline, you know, that movement, that everything in her was able to do that because of her why. So when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, man, you could have, you could be, or you could do whatever you want to do in life.
Give it everything you got. See, put your heart in it. Most people, when they're working on dreams, they don't give it everything they have. And all you can do is enough. Well, see, most people don't do all they can do. Most people go through life holding back.
As long as there's momentum, as long as you're getting up every single day and moving towards your particular ideal, your worthy ideal, you are winning. It is success.
It's up to you. If you want to stay there, you can stay there, and you can murmur and complain and whine, and that's real. But if you want to get up from where you are, there are millions of Eric Thomases who've been where you've been, who've experienced what you've experienced, and we just made a decision that, yo, I don't want this no more. Enough is enough. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired,